Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. If there's one thing you can do to get your health together and to empower yourself as a patient, it's find the right primary care provider for you. Our next guest is here to help us get on the right path to selecting the best one for you as well. Please welcome Dr. Barbara Joy Jones.
Thank you for having me.
Yes, thank you so much for being here. I was literally just talking to Dr. Dave yesterday about finding a new primary care physician. So being a primary care physician yourself, do you hear people talk about that a lot?
Yes, over half of millennials do not have a primary care doctor. In America, one-third do not. Uh-huh. Yesterday, I had a patient come in, 47-year-old female, first time with a primary care doctor. She's like, I've never had one. Let's try this out.
Like, first time ever?
First time ever.
Wow.
I'd only been a specialist.
Wow.
Okay,
wow.
Well, doctor, can you break down what a PCP, primary care physician, actually is? Because maybe they don't understand the importance of it because they don't even know what it is.
Mm-hmm. So a primary care physician is somebody who is the first face of medicine, the first person that you go to. You form a relationship with them, and there's continuity of care through prevention when you establish, and then through chronic conditions if you have them. Also, if it's above their scope, then they know how and who to send referrals to so you can get to the right specialist.
Now, how often should you go see your PCP though?
So if you are young and healthy, that's your annual visit once a year. Mm-hmm. But if you do have chronic conditions, it can be anywhere from 3 to 6 months. Sometimes if you are established with your physician and they know you more deeply and thoroughly, then you can actually push it off because they know you more. So it's like 6 months to 9 months.
Okay.
But usually 3 to 6 with chronic conditions.
Ooh, I mean, there are so many wonderful, qualified doctors out there, but how do you find a good qualifying primary care physician for you that suits your needs and your family's needs?
Yeah.
I would say the best way is by word of mouth. So if you have a friend or family member or a specialist that you've been to that actually knows a primary care doctor, they can kind of matchmake you. They know you, they know the primary care physician, and they can make it a match.
Yeah.
What about possibly going online? Is there any use in that? Maybe WebMD or what is it? Axe Ann? She's one of those people that's online.
We want to ask Angie.
Right.
Angie's next.
Ask her. Angie.
She
yes.
knows.
You're right.
Okay, so there are tons of websites that do allow people to leave reviews. So my personal opinion is to take it with a grain of salt. Here's why. Okay. Most people don't leave reviews, but when they do, they're either really happy
or really angry.
Yes, so you're going to get a lot of 5-star reviews, a lot of 1-star reviews, and you kind of have to take it with a grain of salt. So that's my personal opinion on that.
Yes. Yeah. So what qualities do we look for in a primary care physician? And are you taking any new patients?
Yes. I am taking new patients. I would love to.
Yes.
Look at that.
Look at God. I literally said this yesterday. Okay, so what should I be looking for in you?
So be with connection. Do you feel connected to your primary care physician?
I do.
Do they ask the right questions? Are they curious?
Right.
Are you able to ask questions without me reaching for the door?
Right. To get out of the room?
Yeah, man. Like trying to rush you out.
And then going fast.
I cannot stand
it. It gets on my nerves.
Yes.
And then using stuff in layman's terms. Because see, you know, I'm educated. But like it's certain stuff that I need to be broken down.
Right, exactly.
Yes. So you need to tell me the fa la 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 la. Tell me that's really just my left knee.
Right. Exactly. Somebody that can explain things into you to you in a way that you are able to understand.
Right.
And then there's preferences. Would you prefer a male or a female?
Right.
Different people have different preferences.
Right.
Would you like an older, wiser, seasoned physician who has seen everything, or somebody young and energetic, fresh out of residency like me?
Mm-hmm. Come on, sell it.
Come on, fresh out of residency.
And then there's logistics of are they close to your home? If you're working a 9-to-5, do they have after hours or Saturdays that you can go to?
Right.
Things like that.
Okay.
Dr.
Jones,
I have a question.
Yes.
And I know there's a question here down to the card.
Yes.
But I love that you said you're fresh out of the residency because that means that you're newer into your craft.
Yeah.
Not
yes.
into the craft because you had to go through medical school and all that. So it's not like you're new to the game, but you're new into what's going in your craft. So I have a question. As a black woman, one of the things that we deal with is doctors not taking us seriously. And this has been a whole thing. Like, this has been in the news and everything. So what's some of the advice that you can give me as a black woman when I go to the doctor's office and maybe I have a lump in my breast or I feel like there's something going on that is not normal and they say, oh, it's this, that, and the third, or maybe how can you tell when a patient is overreacting or they really need help? And as a black woman, it's really important that people listen to us, and a lot of times they don't.
Well, I do think with our continued medical education, it has been seen that sometimes African-American women with cardiovascular disease, mm-hmm. that sometimes they have been marginalized because they don't fit that picture.
Wow.
So I would say you need to advocate for yourself. If you know that this is different, this is not what it usually is, you need to really advocate, like, no, this is how it usually is for me. This is completely different.
Yeah.
And let your doctor know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You know, some people skip their primary doctor and go to urgent care. What are your thoughts on that?
So I would say if you're going for diarrhea, a stomach ache, mm-hmm. sinus infection, that's okay. But if you have chronic conditions or are on certain medicines, it is in your favor to go to someone who knows you inside and out.
Yeah.
Because there are drug-drug interactions, and it's basically like mm-hmm. going to someone that you're married to and knows you versus going on continual first dates.
Ooh, that's deep.
That's good.
That's deep.
I like that. But sometimes the urgent care works for people.
Yes,
absolutely. Especially late night, those emergency rooms.
Yes, because you know, the emergency room is a fool.
For those who don't know or understand, what are the different styles of medicine a primary care physician can practice? Like, can I go to my PCP for, you know, if I have a cold or if I have a gynecological situation, or do I need to go see a specialist for that? So what types of things will I go to my
That's
PCP
a good
for?
Question,
well,
Trina.
That is one of the questions that you will ask. So as a family medicine doctor, I see diapers to depends. Mm-hmm. And I
right
do,
now, guys.
And I do pap smears and mammograms mm-hmm. and prostate exams for the men. I do primary care, and I hand them off when it's out of my scope.
Gotcha.
Okay. So, yes.
That's good
that
well,
you do.
Think available pieces
under the whole umbrella.
Yeah. Some of them won't do that.
I'm gonna have to call you too.
So we appreciate you coming today.
Thank
you so much for shedding light on what a PCP really is. Be sure to follow Dr. Barbara Joy Jones on her Instagram at TheModelDoc. Thank you so much for being here.